Hello friends, welcome you all. Today we are going to learn about the exercise number 12 of course Into 354 for the semester 5th new, and the course title is Pest of Crops and Store Grain and Their Management. The exercise number 12 includes the study of different insect pest population of the sugarcane and their management. As you know that the sugarcane is the one of the most important cash crop in Maharashtra as well as in India. So we should know about the different insect pest population which infest the sugarcane crops, and it will be reduce the yield in that crop. So let us start. Which are the different insect pest and non-insect pest population which attack on the sugarcane crops and they cause a yield loss? The first category of the pest, it is according to their feeding habits. The name is sugarcane stem borer complex. In that sugarcane stem borer complex, there are the four major borers which attack in sugarcane and cause a yield in severely. The first one is early shoot borer, then top shoot borer, internode borer and root borer. These all borers, it is comes under the order of the Lepidoptera, hence the damaging stage of these all borers is the caterpillar. So let us start one by one. The first borer is the early shoot borer. The name itself indicate that this shoot borer, it attack in sugarcane at a early stage. The species is Chilo infusca talus. There are the four life stages which in their life cycle. The first one is eggs. The female moth lays her eggs in a group on the leaves. After the hatching from the eggs, the caterpillars emerge out, and the caterpillar it enter into the main stem and start their feeding. The pupation is also occur inside the stem. So let us start how this caterpillar of the early shoot borer it attack on the sugarcane. This caterpillar just make a small circular hole just above the ground level on the stem. It's one of the holes which is created by the larva of the early shoot borer, and it enter into the main shoot and feeding inner contain of the shoots by this caterpillar, and due to their continuous feeding inside the stems, it causes a one characteristic symptom. So that symptom is called as a dead heart symptom. This is the dead heart symptoms produced due to the feeding of the caterpillar. And this dead heart, it can be easily plowed due to their feeding. Okay. Then the next is top shoot borer, Scricophaga exoptalis. The name itself indicates that this borers or the caterpillar of the borer, it attack on the top portion of the sugarcane. The female moth lay their eggs on the leaves in a group or in a masses. At an initial condition, before reaching towards the main stem, the caterpillar attack on the leaf holes or the leaves by making a small circular holes on the surface of the leaves. It is a series of holes. That holes is also known as a short hole or short hole appearance of the leaves. This is the first characteristic symptoms. Second, the internal reddening of the midrib of the leaves is caused due to the feeding of this caterpillar of the top shoot borer. Then this caterpillar, it is entered into the main stem and feeding inner content of the stems and reaching towards the top portion of the sugarcane, and as a result of feeding, in case of severe infestation, the top portion of the sugarcane plant, it become a bushy in appearance or bunchy top in appearance, and this is the characteristic symptoms by the feeding of the caterpillar of top shoot borer. Then next one is internode borer. The name indicate that this borer or the caterpillar of this borer, it attack on the nodal region of the sugarcane by making a small circular holes. When this caterpillar it enter into the main stem by making a small hole, that hole it is plugged with their own excreta and feeding inner content of the stems, and due to their continuous feeding, the inner tissue of the stem it become reddening and the cane become hard, and it gives a one characteristic symptom, that is the reddening and hardening of the canes is due to the infestation of the sugarcane internode borer. Then next and last borer is root borer. Name itself indicate that this borer it attack on the root portion from the soil of the sugarcane stem. This caterpillar it is enter into the stems from the roots and feeding inside the stems by inside the stem or in the cuticle of the stems, and it produces dead earth. But the dead earth produced due to the feeding of the root borer, it cannot be easily pull out as like a early shoot borer. Then the next category of the sugarcane is that sugarcane pest is that the sugarcane sucking pest complex. Why is called a sucking pest? Because the pest having a piercing and sucking type of mouthparts, they continuously suck the cells up from the tender plant parts of the tender plant parts. It includes sugarcane pyrella, woolly aphid, mealybug, scale insect, and also white fly. It also is there. Let us start one by one the sucking pest complex. The first one is a leafhopper, also called a sugarcane pyrella. The scientific name is Pyrella purpurea. The metamorphosis is incomplete, hence having a 3 life stages, eggs, nymphs and adult, and here the both nymphs and adult are the damaging stages. The both nymphs and adult is congregated on the tender plant parts or leaves of the sugarcane, and they continuously suck the cells up from the leaves, and as a result of feeding the leaves become yellowish in color and drier. Instead of the feeding, this pest is also excrete a honeydew-like substance on the honeydew-like substance which develop a black pseudomonal fungus on the plant parts, and the infested leaves of the infested plant it become a blackish in appearance and it directly affect on the photosynthetic rate. Then beside feeding, this pest is also reduce the sucrose percentage in case of sugarcane. The next is that sugarcane woolly aphid. Why is called as woolly aphid? Because the body is covered with a cottony, cushiony or cottony wool like structure, hence known as a woolly aphids. It is one of the aphid species, Ceratobacillus lanigeri. But here the aphids do not lay their eggs by the females. Instead of the egg laying, it directly gives birth to the young ones. The aphids having a alert form or having a wings or do not having a wings. How this aphid is attacking sugarcane? Here in this slide you can see here the nymphs and adult, it is congregated on the different tender plant parts and start their feeding. They suck the cells up from the that tender plant parts. As a result of feeding, the leaves become yellowish in color and dry, and also develop for the black pseudomonal fungus due to their secretion or due to their honeydew-like secretions. And it directly affect on the photosynthetic rate. The photosynthesis is reduced and yield is indirectly reduced. Then next is mealybug, Saccharococcus saccharin. This mealybugs having a this is a female mealybug and this is a male mealybug. The male mealybug having a wings and the female mealybugs do not have a wings. And in case of mealybug, the female adult is the damaging stage and nymphs is also the damaging stage. These are the nymphs and these are the adult or female adult. Both nymphs and adult suck the cells up from the tender plant parts. As a result of feeding, in case of severe infestation, the canes or the leaves become withering and drier. And this is one of the peculiar identification of the infestation of the mealybug. There are some of the black ants. It is attract toward the sticky substance which is secreted by the mealybugs due to their feedings. This is one of the peculiar identification marks of the infestation of the mealybug. Next one, scale insect, Melanopsis glomerata. This is the scales or this is a sucking pest. These scales appears on the sugarcane stem or canes and start their feeding continuously. They suck the cells up from that canes and the cranes become wither and drier and also reduce their sucrose percentage. Then here the next category is subterranean pest. It means that it is a soil pest. There are two major pests. First one is white grub and second one is a termite. The first one is a termites. Here the species is Odontotermes obesus and second species is Microtermes obesi. The termite, it is a social insect, hence having a four different caste: the king, queen, soldier and workers. This is the workers. And the workers is the damaging stage of the termites. This worker is mostly attacked on the stem part or woody plant parts. due to their chewing and biting type of mouthparts, they continue feeding on these things. And the peculiar identification mark is that these workers can feel the affected canes with a soils. This is a soils which is filled by the workers of the termites. And there is one characteristic symptom is that the gappy appearance of the sugarcane plantation is seen in the infested fields. Next one is the white grub, or also called as root grub. Here there are the two species. First one is Holotrichia serrata and Holotrichia consanguine. This pest or this adult will emerge out from the soils because it is hibernate into the soils. After the first monsoon or after the first shower of the monsoons in May month or the June, first week of the June month, the male female beetles emerge out from the soils. It is attracted toward the different host plant or adult host plant. The adult host plant, which may be different trees like neem, bale, babur, bale, shoga, tamarind, like that. And the feeding on the leaves of that host trees, and in at evening condition the male female mating is occurs and the female beetle lay their eggs in soil. Then after the hatching from the eggs, the grubs is emerge out, and the grub, it is present in the soils, and this grub is continuously feeding on the roots and rootlets of the sugarcane. Due to their continuous feeding on the roots and rootlets, this is a C-shaped larva, white in color larva. It is feeding on the root portion. Due to their continuous feeding on the roots and rootlets of the sugarcane crop, as a result of feeding, in case of severe infestation, the infested canes, it become easily pull out. Then some of the drying patches occurs in the infested fields. Then pupa is also occurs in a soils and other, it is hibernating into the soil. This is the white grub. It is one of the major polyphagous pest. Then this is all about the different insect pest population of the sugarcane. Then the main points of this exercise is that integrated pest management in sugarcane. Why we go for the integrated pest management? Because all the insect pest population, it is a very much cause a very much yield in the sugarcane crops. And if we then we use the integrated pest management techniques, the insect pest population we can manage in the limit or manage below the ETL level. The first practice is cultural practices, because integrated pest management itself indicate that how we can manage the pest by integrated way. What is integrated way? We can use a different technique like cultural methods, chemical methods, biological methods, or mechanical method. The first one is the cultural practices. This cultural practices or cultural methods is nothing but the one of the preventive methods, and these methods includes the regular farm operation. With the help of these practices, we can reduce the infestation of the pest. In that, the removal and destruction of affected plant parts or field sanitation, deep summer plowing, interculturing operations, then timely irrigation, crop rotation, these are the some of the techniques we can use. Then in cultural practices, we can also use the resistant and tolerant varieties. These are the different resistant and tolerant varieties which is developed by the plant breeder against the different insect pest population in sugarcane. Then next one is earthing worm. This is a special practice follow in case of sugarcane to avoid the infestation of the early shoot borer. Then we can use or always use the rotten FIM or rotten manures to avoid the infestation of the termites and the white grubs. Then avoid excessive use of nitrogenous fertilizers, because due to the continuous use of the nitrogenous fertilizers, the sucking pest complexes increases. Then irrigation at a closer interval for managing the early shoot borer. Then detrashing. This is the one of the effective techniques. Detrashing means we can remove the lower leaves of the sugar canes or dry leaves of the sugar canes. This is nothing but the detrashing. And detrashing, it helps to reduce the infestation of the all the sucking pests like scale insects, mealybugs, and the sugarcane woolly aphids on the stalk borers. Then intercropping. Onion and garlic or coriander we can use as an intercrop in sugarcane to avoid the infestation of the sugarcane or the shoot borer. And then these are some of the practices we can also use in a cultural practices, like removal of water shoots, then deep harvesting to destroy the different plant parts or stubbles, trash mulching is also one of the important techniques to avoid the infestation on the early shoot borer. Then dig the termitoria. This is the special practice to kill the queen of the termites. Then pair row system, again the insect, again the sucking pest complex. Then wrapping of the canes, it is always used for a sugarcane woolly aphids. Then propping of the canes, it reduces the infestation of the rodents. Then next one is the physical control. For the physical control, we can dig out the termitoria, or we can fumigate the termitoria with the help of the different fumigants. It will be helps to kill the queen of the termites. And then the mechanical control. In that mechanical control, we can use the different traps. In that, we can use a yellow sticky trap for a different sucking pest population, pheromone traps for the lepidopteran insects, a light trap for the nocturnal insects, and we can also collect the different egg masses and the dead herds, because in that dead herds there are some of the hibernating stages is there, or life stages of the insect is there. Then these are some of the practices of the mechanical control: set treatment with moist air, then snap traps made up of bamboo. It is always used in mechanical control to reduce infestation of the pest. Then arhar or tur, it is used as a water crop around the fields to prevent the infestation of the rootstock borer. Then we can collect the different white grub adults which is present on the trees, or adult host trees which is present around our field. We can shake out these adult host trees and collect the beetles, and we can kill these beetle by our own way. Then avoid planting sugarcane under and around the trees in order to prevent the preparation of the white woolly aphids. Next one, biological control. In that biological control, we can use the different predators and parasitoids to reduce the predator, parasitoid and entomopathic fungus to reduce the infestation of the insect pest population of the sugarcanes. Here the Trichogramma chelonis, it is effective egg parasitoids against the sugarcane borers. Then entomopathogenic fungus is used against the termites and white grub specially. Then this one is the Epirikania melanoloca. It is one of the lepidopteran parasitoids which is used as a nymphal parasitoids against the sugarcane pyrrhula. It is one of the effective parasitoids. Then Diphha apidiora and hoverfly or Micromus egorotus are the three different predators we can use against the sugarcane woolly aphids in a sugarcane. Then these are just some of the recommended chemical which is recommended by the CIBNRC, Central Insecticide Board and Registration Committee. All these insecticide is available in a market with a different trade name. You can use this chemical with the recommended dose at a regular interval to reduce or to control the insect pest population of the in the sugarcane. This is all about the study of the insect pest population and their management in case of sugarcane. Okay. Thank you.